This is the Entertainment Buzz.
Further on in the buzz.
And them eyes open like a flag. Hear me now. So about it, dig it way.
Entertainment Buzz are the real thing, man. Sight.
And now our feature presentation.
We want to say a very special welcome to the E-Buzz. I'm DJ Bones.
And I'm Kishima Francis. Also want to say big up to our sponsors. Big up to newcomers, Pickaxe Productions, authentic reggae music.
I damn it, they want big up in them. Big and serious.
Well, you can.
Pickaxe. Well, I know. Right? They're my Pickaxe. Anyway, Pickaxe Productions, authentic reggae music. Big up to you. I'm just doing on the bandwagon thing. But we also want to say a very special thanks to Worthy Park Estate, Rum Bar Rum, truly Jamaican.
Indeed, and they have been with us for a minute, so we
like
say
them
welcome.
Loyal like that, yes.
Absolutely. Yes. Now, tonight, of course, as usual, we have a fantastic show. Big up to our viewers on the internet at irfm.net. Remember, you can log on. Just go to irfm.net, and it is free. Also, big up to the persons who are listening to us at home, whether you're in the, at work or on a corner in a taxi, wherever you are, it is the E-Buzz.
Well, I tell you something. Social media is such an important thing. So we want to say thanks to our friends on social media. If you're not there, follow us on Twitter, IREFM_FM. Of course, Instagram, IREFMJA, or like IREFM on Facebook. I hope I said it fast enough. Right? But I tell you something. It's so nice. Mm-hmm. We have such a great family. Mm-hmm. In here, and this is Max Romeo and his family. You know, we like when Max not easy. The Max is a man is like, yeah, I dare you not.
Welcome officially, Max Romeo, to the E-Buzz.
Max, it's an honor. Not just we're glad you're here, but it's an honor to have you here, sir.
Mm-hmm. Thank you.
And introduce your family to us. Yes. Everybody's here with you.
Well, right here, beginning on this on my left here, this is Romario.
A member of
the Romanal group. Mm-hmm. And here's my wife, Sandra. Mm-hmm.
She usually introduced from first. Mm-hmm. Well. You say she's pretty. Mm-hmm. What's your wife's name?
Huh?
Your wife's name.
Oh, this is Charm.
Charm. Yeah. Mm. That's an appropriate name. Okay. All right. And the gentleman beside your wife?
That's my son. That's Romario.
Romario. Romario?
Yeah. Romario says something, so they know.
Big up yourself now, Romario.
Mm-hmm. And this is my other son. This is Ronaldo.
Ronaldo.
Romanaldo, mm-hmm. Alive.
Of course, you're not can't dead.
And of course, this is. And that's my daughter, Zana Romeo.
She is absolutely gorgeous.
Okay. No, everyone is in music. Everybody's doing music.
Right.
All right, now week after week, what we do on the E-Buzz, we provide a platform for our music artists, upcoming talents, and tonight, of course, we have three members of Max Romeo's family who will be given that spotlight. So that is exactly how we're going to start tonight. But just in case persons who are listening to us miss the hot topics, we're going to get into the hot topics a bit for persons who missed it. And later on, we're going to open the phone lines and give you an opportunity to interact with Max Romeo and, of course, his musical family.
All right, well, first of all, Gollybop's mm-hmm. ex, Chin Chin, boy, Chin Chin, formerly Shauna Chin, mm-hmm. is urging him to be careful following a motor vehicle accident. I was in Mobe over the mm-hmm. weekend, so I know he was at an event, and in my talk about say, boy, skid off a road and draw and brake and all these things. The Bop who complained of to you folks, he's saying that, Kishima, I tell you the truth. When I hear about how him nearly crash, mm-hmm. I could have beat him. Because he said somebody break up in front of him. And then, Max, you know how that go, right? Max is like, why? So if somebody break up in front of him and him was about to go, no pun intended, over a gully. Mm-hmm. And then he somehow corrected it and saw another vehicle, like a Honda Civic, and he went straight
into that vehicle.
Into that vehicle. Yeah, and pull handbrake and all these things.
Well, we're
but
really...
glad he's nobody injured.
Yeah, we're happy that Gully Bop is okay. Chin Chin, on the other hand, she said that she tried to call Gully Bop to say, you know, be careful, but his new girlfriend would not allow him to go on the phone, so she actually used the media to say to him, you know, get well.
Oh my God, I'm in a bad line.
Right, so that's that with that.
Can I be honest with you?
Mm-hmm.
Gully Bop don't need that attention. He new girlfriend, come on, let's date. Leave us alone. come on. I mean, if him sneeze, everybody making us a fuss over it. I mean, he's a bread train and him good, but come on, you know. Mm-hmm. Give us some good news or real news. Let us go move on to something else. I'm gonna be gangster tonight.
Max. Do it.
Yeah, man. If right now I'm seeing people making songs, people doing everything. I don't know if they're riding on a high of him or whatever, but...
But he's not really on a high right now. There was much of a high before. So I think persons actually are waiting and looking for something else from him. And the persons made mention because the accident is serious. It is what it is.
And then in another arm, I heard it wasn't serious. It was trivial. I mean, nobody was injured. The vehicles weren't that damaged. But then, you know what it is? We give thanks that everybody is all right. But, golly, find some way to get some hype, man. Locks. This is ridiculous.
A song will suffice.
Yeah, a song or two.
Yeah. All right. Now, let's get into the music artists. I think we're going to start with, Romaine? Romax.
All right. That's
so talk
a good
to us
name.
A little bit about Romax. And did you feel, tell us, first of all, tell us, who is Romax?
Well, Romax is a calm guy still.
Yeah, we see that.
Okay.
And
what's your age like, Romax? How old are you?
I'm 19.
19.
Really?
Did you feel like, because your dad is doing the music and your other siblings are in it, that, you know, Romax had to do it as well? Or is that genuine passion?
Well, I can say it's a genuine passion, so.
Mm-hmm.
Well, that's good. Because, you know, a lot of times when your parents are in the music business, a lot of them people just feel that you're going to follow your parents. Mm-hmm. And, you know, sometimes it's not your passion. But, you know, you can say, boy, you know, why am I going to do it because I'm a father in it, I'm a mother in it. But you do it because you love it, right?
Yeah.
I don't believe you. Sing something.
Yeah, I'm singing.
Anything.
Rock, me say rock, me say rock. Am I getting true to you? Yeah, I'm work.
Yes.
Yes.
So I sang the song done there, so?
Times get tough, men get greedy. No more money for the needy. Some cry, some kneel and pray. Some lose faith and them gone astray.
Mm-hmm. I like that.
All right.
Nice vibe.
Who is next in line? What's your name?
My name is Azizi Romeo.
Mm-hmm. Azizi Romeo.
All right.
Yeah. And Azizi, you seem like you're the rebel of the lot. How old are you?
I am 16 years old.
You're 16. Did you feel like you wanted to do music because daddy's doing it and your older brother is doing it and your sister is doing it and you want to just do it?
Well, music was more of a calling for me still.
Mm-hmm.
You know, can always remember when
it. He's doing it from his 5 years old.
Mm-hmm.
Really?
His first recording was when he was 7.
Oh, what? Wow.
So, actually, and he tours in Europe with me. You know, he's well known across Europe. He did the 50th anniversary at the O2 Arena in England.
Yeah. Yes.
Amongst all the big boys, you know.
Big boys.
That means you have been given a huge and a massive platform in comparison to what a lot of entertainers who are already established have not gotten an opportunity to touch or to reach. Sing something for us, let us see.
All right. I grow my dread. I grow my dread. It's my choice and I've chose wisely. So I grow my dread, yeah. I grow my dread. Lord, make me grow my dread. I say it's my part, so Lord, make me walk it. Me grow my dread, yeah.
Yeah, and that's my first release.
Boy, that you don't need no more release after that one. Eh?
Now, talk to us a little bit about when you were given such a huge platform to perform on. Was that nerve-wracking for you? How did you handle it? Or did you feel comfortable knowing that, okay, so daddy's there, so I should be fine?
Well, it was more of a family moment for, yeah, it was a Rototom Sunsplash, mm-hmm. Benny Kasim Spain. Mm-hmm. You know, it was the first time, and I graced the stage in Europe, you know, mm-hmm. alongside my father, mm-hmm. and my brother, and it was a very, very extraordinary, exuberant experience.
Mm-hmm. Were you nervous going up there?
Nervous, never nervous.
And I want to talk to you too. Were you never nervous? You know, have them thing there.
No, mom.
No, your sister, she is. If you don't sing, you can enter a beauty contest. Pretty so. Tell us a little bit
about your... Don't let Max have to give you the eye bones.
No. It's all right, man. I call it as I see it. Mm-hmm. Talk to us about your music. How would you describe your music? And yeah, we'll sing something to it.
Mm-hmm. Well, my music is strictly roots, you know. I like to keep it as rootical as my dad did.
Mm-hmm. Right. And I like your brother. Your brother said he might grow him dread, but you grow for you.
Yeah, I've been straight there, done out. That. Yeah.
All right. Talk to us. Sing something for me.
Well, I have a song that is being played frequently on IRE, your station, by Uncle Muta Baruka, Ray Rasta. Mm-hmm. Mm-hmm. It goes.
Hey, Uncle. Hello.
Well,
Max, that's true.
What a respect, yes, he is.
Yes.
Well, I'm a brother, so it must be my uncle.
Yeah,
a black brother, so. You know?
Yes, yes. Let's hear it.
Them are going like them, no Ray Rasta. Discriminate Rasta. Yes, them underrate Rasta. Emperor Selassie, I master. Yes, them magwa like them waffle Rasta. Waron comes call Rasta. Tell them Cezanne Acho Rasta. Tell them Max Romeo and my father.
Yeah. Me could have been telling that too. you know, it's so wonderful. That a veteran musician could have his kids, you know, loving the music. It's not that he forced you into it, right? It's a calling. Every time we talk to each one of you, you're saying it's, you know, it's something that you wanted to do. It's a calling. And, you know, your father's like, yo, you see how me I go and go, ooh, I'm not for sing. That was not it, right?
It wasn't.
Well, the whole thing, you know, nobody come on this earth have to stay forever, you know.
No, you're right about that.
So when I make my exit, you know, like Bob said, I was tired for some of my face. Well, I see three more on my face.
Yeah.
Maybe there are more to come in the farmer grand. You know what I mean?
Right. Yeah. Obviously, this is a very close-knit family.
Very.
Right? Mm-hmm. The wife, she sing too?
Well, in the bathroom and the kitchen.
All right. I would love for her to think of this as a large bathroom, a large kitchen.
Yeah, why not?
Why not? Let us hear what you have, darling.
Yeah, come on, mommy.
Come on, mommy. Yeah, put her boots her up. Yes.
I will go and keep it real.
Yes.
Go and have them back.
Yes.
And watch them and protect them. Manage yes. them and, you know, but. Yeah. Singing part enough for me.
You know, I don't think so. I believe you can sing very well. And most times when people shy away from singing is when they are the best singer.
Look, you hear Max call it.
Yes. Give it one note. And we're all right. Sing something. Max, tell her. Okay. Come here. All right.
Lucifer, son of the morning, I'm gonna chase you out of earth.
See, watch it. You see what I'm talking about now? You see it? Well, I'm going
to
tell
you.
All
right, now talk to us a little bit more about your experience. How do you feel like a need to say keep what you do rootical?
Yes, I do, because today I realized that a lot of us start with the roots, mm-hmm. and then we tend to switch it up a bit. You know, I don't want to switch. I want to keep it like this, and there needs to be more people like me who keep it roots, you know, because young people nowadays, they don't really know anything about the roots, you know, so.
And it's impressive to see someone as young as you are speak the way you do. How old are you?
Well, right now I'm 21.
Right now? Could be 22
are
a little
serious?
Later.
Yes, I am serious.
I absolutely thought you were maybe 15.
That's good.
People tell you that, right?
Yeah, I get that.
No, what I want to ask the young performers, Max, I want to ask them, 19, 16, 21, how do you balance school and your music, especially when you go out on the road to tour with your dad?
Well, at first it was a bit, to be honest, it was hard to balance both music and school. I can't even recall even missing some time in school already because I have to go and earn a dollar, you know.
Right.
Hear him, man.
Yeah, so I've been growing. I've been growing into a man just like my father, and my mission is to be just like my father, because
that is awesome.
He inspires me every single day. I'm a mom as well. Mm-hmm. Yeah, so I want to say in front of everyone that's watching,
millions,
I thank you.
Wow.
Really thank
you.
I don't think I need to say anything more.
You say enough. Wow.
Yes, yeah, so the school, it was hard at first, but now I am really concentrating into trying to enter Edna Manley School of Arts. So that's the focus for me right now.
When I look at this...
How about your older brother?
Well, like...
I mean, how do you balance music and school?
Oh, well...
Welcome back!
Yeah. Well, I do my music like my homework sometimes, so... Yeah, when I have my time, I can sit back in a studio and record my demos and get them mixed and ready.
They have their own studio. You know?
Of course. Nothing less is uncivilized.
They have their own band. He plays bass, he plays keyboard.
You know, one of the things is when you have a family so unified, I always believe in unity is strength. We'd like to talk about the family unified in terms of putting up music together. The kids are doing things. Can we look, your fans and your followers and your friends, can they look out for something from everybody together, like an album?
Sure.
When can we look out for that?
We already have one, Father and Son's album.
So what's about your daughter?
To the daughter.
No, she wasn't there yet.
Well, you need to put one on with Richie.
It's coming.
All right, where is it? Is it out already?
Yeah. Father and Son, yeah.
Where can we get it?
It's not released in Jamaica.
No.
You know.
It doesn't matter.
It's available.
I'm sure it's a download.
It's under download.
All right, so iTunes and
that's
all
right,
of those things. Yeah. And it's just called Father and Son's.
Max, you are my Father and Son's album.
No, that is awesome.
Max, you speak a lot about Europe. What is your impression in terms of music that you're doing? You're doing it not just for Jamaica, but you're doing it specifically for the European market?
Yeah, Jamaica is a kindergarten, you know. Mm-hmm. You got to go to university.
Why you say that?
University is international.
No, why you call Jamaica?
If I said kindergarten, it's a learning stage.
Mm-hmm.
When you leave here, you got to take it out there. There's a lot of music don't leave the airport yet, you know. And you guys, really onto it. And I don't think the media is paying much attention to what's happening out there with us as the older artists, you know. They're losing out on a lot.
Do you think veterans don't get that recognition that they rightfully deserve locally?
No, we don't.
Why do you think that is?
I think we've been shadowed, you know, being overshadowed by more of the dancehall type of music, you know. You turn the radio on, and that's all you hear. You seldom hear, Delroy Wilson, or Dennis Brown, or Ken Boone, or a Max Romeo, I would say.
Of course.
You seldom hear. You know, you just give a news about Gully Bop. You know,
I just thought he does not work the news.
So it's a whole comedy thing, you know.
I understand. What would you like when, as a Jamaican, your family is here, your kids are here, your wife is here? In terms of the music market, what would you like to see the market bestow to you as a veteran and your children who are here with you. You know, we've had people here, also veterans and so on. Mm-hmm. When you look at what is happening, obviously you're focusing more overseas because
I'm flying the flag overseas.
Right. But obviously you do that because you don't get what you should get.
I don't think I fit in right here.
Why you don't think you fit in here?
Because I'm not being exposed. I've got 40 albums. How much do you know?
I know 40.
No, I don't think so.
All right, 39. Yeah.
But I'll be honest.
I don't.
You know what also happens to sometimes, Max? I'm in agreement with you. That veterans don't rightfully get the love that they should get. Also, in the same breath, a lot of times veterans don't feel the need to say promote or push out their material or give if there is new material. Mm-hmm. So sometimes that also happens. Like they expect or anticipate to say, look, X is supposed to have it because I am. Mm-hmm. You understand? So sometimes that is also a probability why that doesn't happen. And then the situation, it is real. I'm not making up any excuses for it because it does happen where good music and great artists.
We used to do that, you know. We used to go to the radio stations when there were libraries. Now there's no library. A guy got his pouch.
We have playing
from his pouch. So
we have
a
library.
You get what I'm trying to say?
I'll agree with you.
Okay.
The libraries are here.
But it's not being used, is it?
It's not being used.
Okay.
And to be honest with you, if you are an artist in Jamaica and you want to get your thing promoted, well, you're an example. You'll say that I don't fit in here, depending on. You just mentioned something in terms of Gully Bop. We just mentioned Gully Bop or something, or somebody else.
Yes.
And the veterans now seem to be promoting heavily overseas. Yes. Do you feel that the love that you get abroad is way stronger than here?
Yes.
In terms, if you could compare it on a scale of 1 to 10, how would you compare it?
I would give Jamaica 6.
6.
Yes.
And Europe?
That's where I get my food.
So I'll 10.
Yeah.
All right. We respect your honesty.
What advice would you give to upcoming entertainers, Max, who are not privy to being a part of your family, like your children, who are getting the real information, details, education about the business? What would you say to a young and upcoming entertainer who is concentrating heavily on getting the acceptance here in Jamaica?
It's not an easy road.
Mm-hmm.
An overnight success doesn't come overnight. Everything takes struggle and hard work. Lyrically, they got to start writing lyrics that is acceptable, that is understood, understandable, and acceptable abroad. You know, you can't just stick the gun and put on the situation to Jamaica, you know, if I can use that word.
You used it already.
I apologize.
Yeah, I heard.
And that one is actually a fruit.
Okay.
Yes. Right.
All right. Yes. You know, it's that stigma. That doesn't leave the airport yet.
Mm-hmm.
Right.
You know, some of it, a little sneak out, a little, you find it in Toronto, Canada.
It
doesn't go worldwide, you know.
Okay.
And that's why it keeps talking out in the people's ears. And tell the truth, in most cases, it's not acceptable, you know. They don't understand it. It's not that it's not good or what. They just don't understand it.
Do you, what's your perception of dancehall?
I don't know it. I'm a roots and culture guy, man.
Mm.
I don't know.
That you don't know it, are you saying that it doesn't have a space or a place?
It has a space
has
and
to.
Its place. It mm-hmm. has to. It's been around for near 40 years.
Mm-hmm.
You know.
And you know, Max, when I look at your kids, they're your younger generation. I'd like to hear from each one of you. What do you think of dancehall? Because sometimes the dancehall is more of an appeal to the younger generation. Miss Beauty,
I think
Queen?
I want to start with Rebel.
Yes.
Yeah.
Rebel Romeo.
Well, music is music, you know? And the dancehall, to honestly tell you the truth, I never really got the chance to listen dancer because my father was always there to guide me, you know, make sure mm-hmm. it's everything positive because love is the mission, you know.
So you think that dance hall is not positive?
Well, songwriting, different topics. Sometimes a man might just sing.
We have positive dance hall.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, there are a few. I heard one today.
Yeah, they're very positive dance hall.
I heard one today that really hit me as I hear it. First time I hear it.
White name.
Every root of a mouth, the taxi man.
And who's singing?
I don't know.
All
right. But it hit me right away.
Every root of a mouth, the taxi man?
Every root of a mouth, the taxi man.
Well, yes. Well, and it hit me because it's true. You don't use Gillette. No deodorant.
All right, we have a break coming up, and then after the break, we're going to go with
Max.
We
don't really hear your skill yet, you know. We know your skill, but for the people who are under a rock, they don't know your skill. Take us to a break, you know, your style. You know, talk us to a break, yeah, sing us to a break.
As I was slowly passing an orphan's home one day, and stopped just for a moment, just to watch the children play. Alone a boy was standing, and when I asked him why, he turned with eyes that could not see, and he began to cry. I'm nobody's child, I'm nobody's child, just like a flower, I'm growing wild. No mommy's kisses and no daddy's smile, nobody wants me, I'm nobody's child.
Absolutely
going
amazing.
Going for a break, soon forward.
Soon forward.
Have me know. Every route have a frozy taxi man.
Rumba vodka!
Rumba,
Rumba vodka!
The spirit of cool.
Quadruple distilled. That's four times.
High style.
Clean.
Crisp.
Good.
Rumba vodka!
Rumba vodka!
As good as it gets!
No fumes.
More fun!
Rumbar Vodka!
The spirit of cool!
Rumbar Vodka! The spirit of cool!
Cool! Cool!
Enjoy responsibly!
Rumbar!
Pickaxe Production presents Danny Axman All-Stars featuring Danny Axman, Lucky D, George Nooks, Public Report, Baga Case, Big Stitch, and many, many. You can reach us at www.pickaxeproduction.com. Follow us on Instagram, Facebook, and Twitter.
When they listen to Irie, everybody loves Irie.
Yep. Wow. You know, I tell you something. When I listen to these beautiful children, but my girl, no, sir. It's like you're born a range. You just a shot every time.
All right, I want to say welcome back to those of you who are just joining us. You're inside the E-Buzz. We have Max, Romeo, and family inside the studio. I want to say big up to our sponsors. Big up to Worthy Park Estate, Rum Bar Rum, Truly Jamaica.
And we want to say a very special welcome. welcoming every way. Brand new sponsor, Pickaxe Productions, the way it sounds. Pickaxe. And of course, they are all about authentic reggae music. All right, we're going to be going to a very special feature now. It's called Social Media Highs and Lows with the beautiful Tony T. Like this.
So what we say?
Hey, I'm Tony T with the 411 on what's popping on social media with your favorite celebs. What's hot, what's not, your social media highs and lows. This week, check, 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 Agent Sasko has the spotlight. Here's your social media high.
I'm telling you, day in, day out.
Agent Sasko has been consistently promoting his first studio-length album in over a decade, Theory of Reggaetivity, and he is reaping the rewards of promotion. Sasko's first full reggae album debuted at number 3 and now sits at number 6 on the Billboard Reggae Albums charts, and it's receiving praise from a variety of prominent mainstream media. The Feather, The Washington Post, and ABC News are the latest to give Agent Sasko the thumbs up in their reviews. All ABC know say, I don't know, like ABC 123 rhyme thing, Bordeaux to Billboard with a straight, commented one of his fans under Sasko's screenshot of ABC News review. Theory of Reggaetivity was also featured in the iTunes US Store Hot Albums page on iTunes. Just last week, Agent Sasko was spotted with Grammy Award-winning rap artist Kendrick Lamar in a trending social media photo taken at the Usain Bolt Tracks and Record in Kingston. So yesterday was International Women's Day, and Jamaica's newly appointed Prime Minister, the Most Honorable Andrew Holness, decided to surprise all the females at the office of the Prime Minister, including his newly elected Member of Parliament wife, with flowers. The video is up on all his social media pages, and yes, Jamaica loves it. Go check it out. Prime Minister Holness continues to earn cool points on social media. What's not? Shade.
Oh, Lord, 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 Lord.
It seems our dancehall artists enjoy sitting under the shade on social media rather than crossing borders and making things work, work, work for them. Over the past week, Beanie Man and Movado have been the latest to dab at each other using Instagram fingers. Movado made a post at his mansion captioned, "So Basil, Gully God, Big League." Days later, Beanie planted a whole tree with a post of him holding his Grammy saying, "Nuff man in a big league, yes, but nuff of them never win the league yet, or carry home the trophy or no medal. We always in a the league, never get relegated. MVP for 10 years straight. Hashtag we run road. Jano Gully God, I see your fans saying, them in a Grammy league, we in a mansion league. But which league is the real deal? Can't we all just accept every man runs a league of his own? Right now it look like a just social media leak some artists interested in. Everybody social media hot, but who really run road? That's the deets on your social media highs and lows. I'm your girl Tony T. Who will it be next week? Watch that post. I'm out.
Yep. I tell you this. I am loving that. You know, Tony, you're loving mix up emails, huh? Tony's like, well, you know, so and so and so, so. But you know what it is? We want to say welcome back to the E-Buzz. And of course, we have the talented family here, this awesome family, Max Romeo and his beautiful wife and his three talented children here. Welcome again, right? Didn't I hear for your tune? Right? One of the things, we talked about the albums, right? Will the children be doing anything individual? Or has that been done already?
Yeah, man, it's done. Romario is into EDM music.
He's
just completed, actually mixing his EDM album now.
Oh, yes, to me.
Yeah.
Mayu, that's so you move. Yeah? But you know something, you know, with EDM, you have to make it look a bit louder than that, you know. As a, you have to talk, look louder. You have to.
Yeah, man.
All right, good. We're good, maybe we work with that, right? Yeah. And of course, and what about you, my brother?
Well, I have a single released already. It's titled Grow My Dread. It's available on iTunes.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah, and I have an upcoming single coming now. It's titled System Failure.
What I was asking you, because Max was talking about father and sons, will each child be doing an individual album? That's what I wanted to find out.
Okay.
Right? Is that going to be happening?
Yeah, it is. Zana Romeo's album is in the mixing. His album is mixing.
Zana Romeo has an album in the mixing.
Yes. Yeah, that's his name.
Right.
And Azizi is in the mixing. Mm-hmm. And he's doing an idiom.
So everybody have something coming out.
Right, and I got an album coming out.
Well, you got 40 album already, you know. So what, 41?
Since I got 70.
No, he might got
and I in the business 50 years before him. So. Sorry, my boss, that's your
memory. No, but look here. We're all about having fun here. Do you think that beautiful wife of yours will do an album too? Because this is her saying that she doesn't, you know, she sings in the bathroom, but she has a wonderful voice.
No, we handle the music. She handle the money.
Darling, you're my best friend. All right. What you say, you handle? The money? Me, I come link you. All right. But it's awesome because, so Max is doing an album. And every child here has an album in the mix.
Yeah, we're going on tour start May.
I was going to ask for a release date anytime soon for each album. Are we going to do it all at once or everybody has a separate time?
I might have an upcoming mixtape working on with Roots Selector Yardcore to be dropped the ending of this month.
Yes.
Yeah.
Okay, wonderful. Right. So yeah, move.
Yes, I'm moving.
Just you, undiluted. Any collaborations?
No collab. Just me alongside the hardcore.
Okay.
Can I hear a little bit about the album from the children? Like, how would you describe your album?
Well, my album is roots rock reggae, and it's titled Message Music, which is music with a message, you know. And my album is based. My album is based on productivity, if you understand where I'm going, you know. It's times are changing now. It's time for something different and something positive, something uplifting, you know. So that's basically what I am doing right now.
Mm-hmm. Yeah. How involved are you in your project? Or is it basically like your dad help you with it to like, inject like his ideas also in your project, or is it a situation where it's your work, it's all you, so you get full creative control? How is that?
Well, it's my work. I write, mm-hmm. I produce, I even compose, I play keyboards. Mm-hmm. So I alongside Jalanzo from the Dubtonic crew.
Yes.
Yeah, I've been working with him for a long time.
Really?
From ever since he
right.
was
right, you're only 16, so yeah, like a couple of years.
Yeah, he was the person who recorded my first song.
He was 5 years old.
5 years old, a long time. Yeah. Long time.
And he will be right. A
veteran.
Yeah,
veteran. Yeah, man, say it again.
Young veteran.
Yeah, man. No, veteran.
So like how you you have full control of your creative process. Do you take advice from your dad and other persons who may have, you know, more knowledge about the situation? How do you deal with that?
Yeah, well, definitely, because it's a family effort, you know. So, mm-hmm. And my father, he has a lot of experience in mm-hmm. the business.
I would hope so. 40 albums, I would hope so.
Yeah.
Yes.
Yes. Right.
And even my Jalanzo as mm-hmm. well.
And why I have to ask that question, Max, because oftentimes, like, you know, when you have musical families or especially a dad who is well known and established and your work is a particular type of work, you find that children oftentimes feel a necessity to say trod in a similar footstep. They may also have ideas and creative ideas of their own that sometimes get stifled because that is not the overview or the outlook or the direction in which you want to go. So.
I don't dictate to them and what mm-hmm. they do, you know. My bedroom is around there, the studio is around there, and there's a security system, cameras in the studio. So I lie down on my bed, watch them working and listening to everything.
Mm-hmm.
And if I hear anything that's not really,
you know,
then I'll say, hey, change that line or something like that. But I give them mm-hmm. total control of what they do.
Well, I tell you something, Max. What your kids have said earlier is that it's not like they were forced into doing the music business.
No.
They all said they had a calling to do it. And mm-hmm. once they said that, I mean, you can guide them, but as you say, you give them full autonomy in what they're doing.
Right.
And if they were not comfortable, because she could be a beauty queen, he could be an accountant, probably he's a doctor, somebody could be something else.
Mm-hmm.
But they love the music. And of course, they have the talent.
Yeah.
I know, as a father, I know that he'll push them and try to get the maximum in terms of their potential.
Yes, I told them all I got to give them apart from education is music.
Right.
You know, everything is pertaining to music. Everything that I own in my life comes through music.
Sure.
And they see, you know, so therefore they decide to go along that way. And I make sure that they have their own publishing set up, you know.
Wonderful. That was the next question I was going to ask.
They got the booking agent in France, Mediacom.
And royalties and everything?
Everything is okay.
All right. You know, talk to us a little bit about, let us get into the human side of this thing. You love the music. This is what you do for a living.
Mm-hmm.
But let us get into the other side. You're a family nonetheless, wife and kids with you.
Mm-hmm.
Let us talk about hobbies, things that you like to do separate apart from music. Some people would say, my hobby is music. Some people will say, well, I like kick football, me like this, me like that. Tell us what you like to do.
Well, last thing I said, that's one of the
football, not true.
Along with music, that's my passion. That's what I am passionate about.
So you work and play?
Yeah.
Mm-hmm. How about you, Mr. Quiet?
Well, Mr. Quiet love football.
See there? Mm-hmm. Why is that? It's a question of lame. Mm-hmm. Well, I don't know. And the beauty queen.
And that is Ronaldo.
Well, I have interest in photography, so I enjoy taking pictures.
Really?
Not just selfies.
Yeah, very professional camera.
Yeah, I have a professional
What's your favorite thing to capture?
Smoke. I like to take pictures of people in smoke, whether it's smoking or just by a fire.
Okay.
Yeah.
If I bring you with a car, when I work so good, so when you start it up, you can.
Okay.
Why smoke though? That seems, you know.
Because the smoke is it's calm, you know.
And like how it is captured, like with the still life.
Yeah, the shape. Yeah, you're not sure how the picture will turn out because it's smoke.
And it always keeps going up, and it's up you want to go, isn't it?
Yeah.
Ah.
Open as I am.
Yeah, Max. That's
and
true.
The fact that you said that, it tells me a little bit about your creative process and like how you think. Let's chat a little bit about your work and what you're doing. Is there anyone locally that you would like to work with musically?
Apart from me.
that is a very tight question. Well, you know, there are other young artists like me who I would wish to work with production-wise because, you know, we have a record label. I like to get involved in producing some people on the same mission as myself.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah, so that's what I want to do locally right now. Just to get other young artists who's trying to get out there involved in what we're doing.
Mm-hmm. Romario it is?
Yeah.
What is your plan of action? Like, where do you see yourself, say, in another 5 years or so, musically?
Well, I see myself in the top, maybe the top 7 or top 10. Because my kind of music is much easier than them kind of music.
What's your kind
What's
of music?
What's them kind of music versus yours?
All right, reggae and EDM.
Right. Okay.
The younger generation more catch on to my music.
Mm-hmm.
Right.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah.
Do we have any of your music here?
Yeah.
I would love to hear.
DJ Brian, can we get a musical mix of the children?
Yes.
Yeah.
Yeah, let's hear that.
Start with the EDM.
Your Rasta, Emperor Selassie, I am my master.
soul is a roaring lion. My heart's ignited by Zion. I will never stray or lose my way. Cause we get judged by the dread on our heads. And I be a propaganda them spread. We never take offense from what they say. I listen.
You know, Daddy Max, what I want to ask you, how do you feel about EDM?
I haven't heard much of it, but the little that I've heard, I mean, Romario turned me on to it, and it's just a different type of music. It's more soothing, you know?
EDM is soothing?
Yeah, depends on what
how you look at soothing.
How you look at soothing, okay. Yeah?
All right. Mm-hmm. Well, you know, EDM is a big deal. And of course, especially in Europe, they've tried to bring festivals here. I don't know if there was supposed to be one coming up. Yeah. Mm-hmm. I think it was put off.
Yeah,
I think that is put off.
Mm-hmm.
Yes, but they were all make our talk. We can't hear. Mm-hmm.
Max, let's talk to you a little now. For Jamaicans, younger Jamaicans, and persons out there who are probably under a rock and don't know your story. Share your story. Chat to us a little bit about how you got started in music.
Well, I've said this about 1.4 million times. Well, I started actually working with a small label as a little, you know, what you call a runner, taking samples to the stores and things like that. And then I get the opportunity to do my first song, which was a song called I'd Buy You a Rainbow. Which did well on both charts at the time. We had two charts going, JBC and what was it, RGR, at the time. And
yes,
it went as far as number two. That was my first effort, and that kind of spurred me to
do more.
You know, and I started out with a group called Emotions, which, Light Shakespeare, Robbie Shakespeare brother,
right,
and a guy called Kenneth Knight.
Mm-hmm.
We did about 5 songs, I think, for under the Caltone label.
Right.
And one guy died, the next one migrated. So I end up as Max Romeo.
Mm-hmm.
It was a struggle, but like I said, it's 52 years ago.
Mm-hmm.
But I'm still at it.
And wow. When you were doing it, you didn't have like the kind of guidance and protection that you're, you know, giving to your children. No,
because there was nobody in my family who was in my as relatives who was in the music business. There was a far distant cousin, as B.B. Sin is a far cousin, but there was no one to actually. Matter of fact, I had this little box guitar, and we used to go under the bridge.
Yes.
And people used to throw things at us down there, you know, and things like that. We go through a lot of struggle.
Mm-hmm. You know, sometimes in life, struggles kind of help to shape an individual's personality and character. Mm-hmm. And listening to your children speak and tell their story, what I observe is that they have been extremely sheltered.
Yeah.
How do you think this will affect them in the long run? Or do you think that they will garner enough knowledge where they're going to be okay?
Of course, because I show them the positive side of life of all times, you know.
Mm-hmm.
You know, I show them be truthful, you know, in what you do. You know, be loyal, be dedicated to what you do, because that's the only way you're going to actually excel, you know.
Be true to
you
yourself.
You have to be there for yourself, you know.
One of the things, though, is that we have to also, they're young, impressionable minds and talented, EDM and culture. In terms of what they present.
Yeah.
But in terms of the business itself, it's a very rough business.
It is.
It's a cutthroat.
I know.
And that's being nice
so, yeah,
about it.
True.
Do you kind of give them a lead up or a heads up in terms of what to expect on the cutthroat side of things? Because it is there. It can't hide. It's not going anywhere.
Yeah, I do.
Yeah, and are they prepared for it?
Supposed to, but you see, the difference with my time and their time
is very different.
It's a big difference. They're not going to go through what I've go through.
No, you had it rough.
Right. You know, yes. I had to go to Bonnie Lee and Lee Perry and 90 for money. They go to the publishing company for
and
the download.
And right.
I got a kid in university.
Right.
And she her fees and everything is paid from download.
Right.
So... Mm-hmm. It's okay.
I tell you something though, you know, Max, I need to hear your wife talk because she has a lot saying, but it's like because they might not hear with that hearing her good.
Is it challenging managing everybody? Because
yes.
We understand mommy mode and you're a momager. So, I mean, is it challenging, bro? Like just, you know, like you're constantly on the grind?
Yeah, well, sometime, but not all. When they are at home, not that bad. But when they are on the road, you know, you have to constantly behind them. And, well, as a mother, this is what I'm here for. I'm here to protect the back straight. And that is what I do. I show them the bad, the good.
Mm-hmm.
So
and the ugly, don't leave that out.
So they, you know, they have a lot of understanding.
Mm-hmm.
I sit down and I explain, and I say, well, you can do it that way, or you can do it that way.
Have you ever given them an advice and they're like, Jano, mommy, I really have to.
Yes, a lot of times.
Not happening.
Yes, then when them done, them come back, boy. You should have listened to what mommy saying. Mm-hmm. Do that
so you allow them to make the mistakes.
Yes, I allow them a lot of time to make
because
the mistake.
Because that's what I was going to get into in terms of specifics.
Yes,
in
I terms allow of them.
The music business, as I was just saying to Max, in terms, it's a rough business. And you know the business. Are there specific things you tell them? And we're talking specifics now in terms of what to do and what not to do.
Well, they are young and they are talented.
Why it's important, yes.
So it's not here in Jamaica, they do a lot of things without even, they do a lot of shows But most time, me and daddy don't bother go. Allow them.
Them go on.
Them go on.
Mm-hmm. Oh, yes.
There's a lot of things what I have to I tell them. Don't you go there. Don't let anybody come to you, come tell you that they want you to do any music. Mm-hmm. Don't sign any paper.
Ah.
All those things mommy tell them.
Those are good specifics.
And you don't know cocaine, yes. You're not going to know it because it's not in my house.
Right. So, you know.
Thank you, Max.
Yeah. Don't sign it. Because the other day they did this business for this girl.
Mm-hmm.
What the father approved. And they did it. And it, I don't know, she, when she was to release the record,
yes,
she did not contact us. She don't, we don't know
nothing. Just release it.
Mm-hmm. Yes, and when we call her, they call her about it, and I don't know what she tell them, but I was in London, and they called me, and said, mommy, she's this. I said, okay, I'll call her.
Mm-hmm.
And I call her, and she said to me, who is you? So I said, oh, I'm Asana's and Ramar and Ronaldo's mommy.
Yes.
Well, I don't want to hear anything. I said, okay, then you don't have to hear nothing more from me.
Mm-hmm.
And I just contact my publisher.
And sort it out.
Sort it out.
Right.
Mm-hmm.
Because you see, I respect that because you obviously understand how the business was. The business was not between you and the person. But maybe the publisher or...
No, the father. Maxie was there.
Right. Oh, right.
And right. Decide for them to do the song for, because she was this young girl from America, as a young mm-hmm.
producer.
Mm-hmm. Yeah.
Yeah.
So did you give Max hell for that ugly deal?
No. I know about the deal, but I wasn't mm-hmm. really involved
right.
in it.
So when
time.
Him called, when you called and him said...
All right, let me tell you what my mostly do. It's when we come on to the music, we
yes.
can't allow them. But it's when the fending part come.
The food.
So me step
in. Because we're not dead for hunger wrong, yeah.
No.
Wow.
If you allow them,
yes,
they're going to get exploited.
Of course.
Because there's, it's enough time. When people come and say, Max, I said no. And Max is in the business 52 years. And if you don't stand on the foot, I'm going to get exploited same way.
I feel so bad because I actually thought that Max was 52.
No.
so man, 52 one.
52 years in the business.
Max, that means you are going, you know.
All right.
It's just a number, you know.
Obviously, your number up there.
Yeah, good.
Yeah, go on, good.
A lot of guys would like to be up there.
No, enough of them don't live today.
It is 9:31 inside the E-Buzz. You know, right now, I think we should ask the Romeo family to give us like a musical live vibration to a break.
And
so Max and his children sing with to a break.
How they go do it?
I don't know.
They live together.
They're under the same roof. They can figure it out.
I believe the beautiful.
Kids
boys do not dictate
too.
It.
I'm not a manager.
Whatever you do.
Up.
Whatever you say. Wherever you go. Remember. Kids are people too. Woo. Whatever you do. Woo. Whatever you say. Woo. Wherever you go. Kids are people too.
Take it away.
Little children ain't no toys. They're little girls and little boys. And should be treated with respect. Cause they are the generation next.
Remember, you don't own them. You have only sown them. These precious little people, eh?
Kids are people too.
Yay. Whatever you do.
Right.
Whatever you say.
Whatever you say.
Wherever you go. Remember, kids are people too.
Eh.
Whatever you do.
Whatever you do.
Whatever you say, yeah.
Whatever you say.
Wherever you go,
remember,
kids are people too.
So what we say?
Whatever you do.
Right. Wicked.
Tapa Top Food Hut for tasty, mouth-watering meals. Seaview Drive, Lucy. The time by Tapa Top Food Hut is?
The time by Tapa Top Food Hut is 9:33.
Thank you. Rum bar vodka! Rum bar vodka!
The spirit of cool.
Quadruple distilled. That's
four times
my style.
Clean.
Crisp.
Good.
Rum bar vodka!
Rum bar vodka!
As good as it gets.
No fumes.
More fun.
More fun.
Rum bar vodka! The spirit of cool.
Rum bar vodka?
The spirit of cool.
Cool. Cool.
Enjoy responsibly.
Rum bar.
Pickaxe Production presents Danny Axman All-Stars featuring Richie Canary, Cool Johnny Cool, Winston Grey, Nisha B, Chikwa, Light Jackson, and many, many more. You can reach us at www.pickaxeproduction.com, PICAXEproduction.com, or BPALmusic/BP Records. Follow us on Instagram, Facebook, and Twitter.
Rum bar vodka!
Rum bar vodka!
The spirit of cool.
Cool, cool.
Quadruple distilled. That's
four times
my style.
Clean.
Crisp.
Good.
Rum bar vodka!
Rum bar vodka!
As good as it gets.
No fumes.
More fun.
More fun.
Rum bar vodka!
The spirit of cool.
Rum bar vodka?
The spirit of cool.
Cool, cool.
Enjoy responsibly.
Rum bar.
I would hope so. And of course, right. We're here with Max Romeo and family. We want to say welcome back to the E-Buzz. And I tell you something, lots of things are happening. We're getting to a season where there's so many events happening. Spring break is upon us, right? And of course, Derek Reynolds is going to be online with us. As a matter of fact, he's online right now. I know because I and I have clairvoyancy. Derek!
Go on.
Wait, ask him, man. You're rich again.
Yeah, man. You don't know. Real rich.
Real rich. Not true. Talk to us. I see a lineup here that I don't even believe is true. So I want you to tell me. It's Long Bay Beach Negril. This lineup is so powerful, I don't believe it's true. Tell us the lineup.
Well, I know, say, I didn't know that link up spring break.
Of course.
I know the 17 year this, but you don't know. So if I see the lineup, I know it's the real deal.
Real
I know
deal.
The Sizzler Kalonji, the headliner.
Yes.
The guy doing a being the man. You know, Bugle, Taros Riley, Jamil. You know, Mr. Spring Break, Singer James, Elf, Tonto Blacks, Real Rich, Super Rich. You know, Colonel Joseph Wheel, Liquor Hero, Danai, Stone Love Sound, King Tafari, crazy thing.
No.
March 12, Long Bay Beach, Negril.
What's the admission to get in and what time is showtime?
Well, you know, so we kick off from another day at Kashima. From another day, we start, you know, I know there's still a lot of trouble for the people, them, in Tafari, Madras, and I also. From another day, and guess what I want? Sizzler Kalonji, Beanie Man, Idona, and Singer J, Jamil, Taros, we have entertainer versus the fans. So, you know, say, the fans. I'll come out, come play with the stars then. So soccer match now the day and them type of thing. That's only about juggle for the people them. And, you know, things like that. Greatness of Spring Break this year.
Talk to us a little bit about Showtime and once and the admission, of course.
Well, Showtime, you know, so we'll kick it off from 9 o'clock. From 9 a.m. 9 p.m., I mean, sorry.
Oh, you frightened
and
me.
Done, yeah, and you know, say, admission is general $2,000 pre-sold. $1,500 VIP, $3,500. And tickets, you can get tickets at Times Square in Negril, Times Square Plaza in Negril,
yes.
Royal Sports in, also in Negril, and Boardwalk Village also in Negril. Those are the tickets outlet.
How your security and parking and all them thing there?
Well, parking, you know, we secure the store every year, because you know, a tourist is tourist versus and the locals, they mix up. So, you know, so we take up the tourists, them, because we want them to come to Jamaica.
More.
And most of them well safe, and, you know. So we have to protect them. So Negril police will be out in full force. Yeah.
Remind us again, Derek, before you go, what, when, where, who?
Go again.
Who them?
Didn't get that.
Yeah, give us the specifics before you go. Remind us again. When is it? Where?
Okay.
Admission? Yeah.
So, you know, say, it's the New York Link Up Spring Break 17th anniversary at Langbeer Beach in Israel, Saturday, March 12th. And you don't say the all day, all night event. You know, say, as you say, we kick off from 9 p.m. until, you know, we say when. So, at the type of show.
By the way, Derek, who are your MCs?
MC Beaky Play, and also Samperman, and also your host.
You better know. Got true. Yeah. Who is that? Amber.
Amber will be in there.
Derek, yes. You don't know. You know, you, actually, first, you should have promoted you.
Exactly, Derek. You. What up, man?
Yes. Derek, watch it. You know, you.
Well, you know, Amber,
your family,
sister,
man. Your family.
So you don't know, say, Amber, add it to the thing. So
of
you don't
course.
Know, say, Amber, if you are listening, you know, so we love you and we rate you.
Amber is listening. She is listening.
All right.
Big up.
Well, Derek, thank you so much. We wish you all the best. So that is spring
break happening
on Saturday.
Yeah, you know, so we have to big up the whole of the Negril taxi man, the man, the bike, mm-hmm. the bikers in Negril. And also, Teka Set, one of the greatest chicken man in Negril. So, you know, we have a bless of Teka Set.
Please.
Not chicken on nice and Teka Set chicken in Negril.
Please to talk to the biker then. All
right, we will not charge you for that ad, but remember, people be careful on the road.
The biker them
yeah,
down there.
Yeah, be careful.
Them.
The bikers in that right to one and Negril.
Then ride fool. Talk to them.
Ride with friends, I'll come on spring break. Ride fool, man.
Them all are riding a patrol. Tell them to stop it.
I hope you know the mouldy taxi man by your road.
Yeah.
I've got my lovely wife, Terry Ann, and my son in the house, you know? So we have to pick them up.
Derek, big up yourself.
Right,
we'll be there
you
on
so
the weekend, right?
So that All is right. spring All break right. happening on Saturday, March 12th at Long Bay Beach in the Grill.
That's an awesome
Make sure
show.
You check
it does
it out.
Well every year. That's a big, big deal. Mm-hmm. Max Romeo and family. I'm so honored to have all the. I mean, this all
right.
Is
at this
not
point,
regular.
I think we can open the phone lines and give our listeners an opportunity to interact with Max Romeo and family. The numbers to call are 974-5051.
974-5043.
Or 974-5079.
Call us right now. Max Romeo and family. Max look extra cool, like him still in a AC every day. You know, man. Like, yeah.
No, Max, what's the latest project you're working on that we can look forward to? An album, upcoming tours?
Yeah, my new album coming out in April, I think.
And that's album number 40?
41.
There 41.
Just checking, mm-hmm. just checking.
And the title is Horror Zone.
Horizon.
Yeah, so.
Horror Zone or Horizon?
It's out. It's out, is it?
It's out.
Yeah, my
it's
wife
out?
Is saying it's out,
it's
yeah.
done by
Leonard McMillan. Yeah, no.
It was done by the Grammy producer, what the Lee Scratch album, Daniel
yes.
Boyle in London, mm-hmm. and it's a Grammy project.
You think you're easy, mommy?
Okay.
Yeah, you're manager, you know? You are the manager, you know?
It came out about 2 weeks ago.
Two weeks ago?
Yeah.
Is it available on digital download?
I
think so.
Yes,
I think so. So iTunes and all the relevant
children
areas?
Are saying yes. So. No, Max, okay. having your young children, them, right? And then this is an era and a time of social media, social network. Are you on social media?
Am I?
Yes.
If you ask,
Daddy,
am I with a problem?
Yes, but not in control. Not
I control
me,
all his social media pages.
All right.
He's active mm-hmm. on everything. Mm-hmm. At Charmax Romeo, that is.
So Twitter,
right.
Facebook.
Right. Persons have already started tweeting. Big up to the persons tweeting on Twitter and Instagram and Facebook are sending their messages. As
we have a caller. We want to say, Buzz through caller, welcome. You're live.
Yeah, man. Blessed, boy.
Blessed.
Shaka warrior fast too.
I would never have thought. Big up yourself, my friend.
Yeah, man, big up.
Yeah, man, bless it, make it burn it, too.
Yeah.
Yeah, man, Irish straight.
Max Romeo and family, big them up.
Yeah, man, Romeo.
Romeo.
Give thanks.
Yeah, man, Romeo.
Yeah, man, they're about. Up
yeah,
and
man,
running.
Yeah, man, positive. Yes, man, sir.
Yeah, virgin.
Yeah, love the melody, you know?
Yeah, man. Give thanks.
Sons and daughters up straight, you see?
Next generation, yeah, man.
Yeah, man, I call them all them things. Clean thing we said to you, them, you see what I'm saying?
Yeah, man.
Yeah.
Yes, princess.
Yes, I am here.
Yeah, man, like the melody and the voice, you know?
Give thanks.
Yeah, man, rolling lion, that's what I say.
Yes, I.
Conquering lion, tribe of Judah, that's what I say.
Yeah.
Yeah, man, warriors.
Yeah, man, peace, listen, love.
All right, give thanks for calling, Shaka.
Yeah, man, whoa, please, let me burn it.
All right, thank you so much for calling.
Another caller, buzz through caller, you're live.
Max, I know you said that album 41 is finished and ready.
Yeah,
how would you describe this album, and how is it different from the 40 other albums that you have done?
This is a more in-depth roots album. You know, mm-hmm. It touched some subject that you have to listen. You know, it's near like Warner Babylon album, but it have a little more in-depth.
You know what I like for you to do, Max, mm-hmm. because you're so powerful. Just say, welcome, caller.
Welcome, caller, to the buzz.
Hello.
Yeah. Hi.
How are you?
We're good. How are you?
Bless.
Okay, Kashima?
Yes.
This is the great Mr. Universe.
Ted Wapman.
Hi, Ted. Wapman,
boy.
How you doing, Bridget? Everything all right?
You know what Mr. Universe ever up? My thing loud in a bone.
Yeah, true, man.
My thing up. But Bones and Kashima first.
Yes.
I have to say congratulations to Mr. McLeod, teacher at the Godfrey Stewart High School, who won Mathematics Teacher of the Year.
Okay, wonderful.
He outdone the whole Jamaica and bring that award to Savlama. And I feel so proud, even though I'm not a past student of that alma mater. But you know I always talk about the Godfrey Stewart School.
Yes.
Yeah, man. So I feel good when I take up the newspaper and see yesterday I see Mr. McLeod, Godfrey Stewart, and I see it on the TV all over. So I feel good.
Yes.
So if a past student listening, Richard Stevens supposed to feel good because he's a past student of that alma mater. You understand? So I have to feel good that I'm a part of it because I'm living in Savlama.
All right, Ted.
So pick up Godfrey Stewart.
Max
and
Romeo.
The artist them.
Yes.
Yes, right away. So you know where I cut you. Go through.
Yeah, you know, to mix up Kashima and Bood. Yeah, man, you know.
Max Romeo and his entire family is here.
Max Romeo, how are you, sir?
I'm good, Mr. Universe. I listen to you all the while. You and Jerry Small and them people are rumble upon radio.
Same you mean, Ted, call all the stations?
Yeah, man.
Call every station.
So, you know, we have to say, you know, the melody that I hear, your entire team that I hear tonight, I know you're going to reach far. You understand? No if, nor no, but about that.
Thanks, man. If you say so, I saw.
Are you
Mr. Universe, man?
Definitely. You see the creativity of the music and the melody. Trust me. It's heart-rending.
Thanks.
You understand? Because you're not doing music, you know. You're doing music for the heart, mind, and the soul.
True.
And you see, when people can feel the music you're doing from inside, that's the greatest thing. That's come like a soul food.
Yeah, man.
All right.
So, you know, just want to say, big up, continue to do what you're doing, because right now you're on the number one media, and you know, say, it's gonna lead.
All right. Thank you so much, Ted. Thanks for calling. So, we're taking your calls right
your call.
Now. We
thank
have
you
Max,
so much.
Romeo, and family in studio. So, Max, you were telling me about album number 41. You're saying that it's a little more in-depth.
Yes, it's touched a lot of subjects, you know, international, worldwide subjects.
Right.
You know.
You don't touch ISIS, though.
No.
Good. No. Don't touch them. They might
for young writers, young people coming in the business musically to start a career of their own, when they are writing, what are some of the key pointers that they should consider to say structure, put together a world song?
Okay.
First, you have to think about other people listening. It's not just the neighbor and the friends. There are people in the international world who is listening.
That's smart. That's
so
true.
Therefore,
that is true.
You have to make sure that your lyrical content is
makes
international.
Sense.
Yeah. Subject matter is relatable to a wider cross section.
Yeah, and the way you put it across, then it will be acceptable out there, and then you'll be in the university.
Yeah. You know, Max, one of the things I'd love to ask you, you've been in the business for a while. Mm-hmm. Your kids are here, your wife is here, and they're in the business also. We love the wife because she handles the money. Mm-hmm. But apart from that, we're talking about the wider sphere of music. Mm-hmm. You hear the young producers out there now.
Yeah.
The music was, you know, in your time. When you look at what is happening now in the music business in the current situation, mm-hmm. do you think it is better, worse? Do you think it is all right? But when you look at what is happening now in the business, in the way people are producing music, the young producers, mm-hmm. In terms of the style of production and the material that they're putting out, what are your thoughts on it?
First, the music become accessible because of the modern technology.
Really. Facebook, you know, the
just a laptop and you got a studio.
That's true. Okay. Yeah?
So you got thousands of laptops. That means you got thousands of studios.
Right.
And thousands of people releasing thousands of music weekly.
By the week, yes, yeah, that's
and
true.
And the buying public can't keep up with it.
Right.
So I think they're just recording music for radio stations.
Okay.
In some cases, because it's just a radio playing it. Mm-hmm. And maybe a few sound system.
It moved too fast. Right.
Okay. I mean, it's good. Everybody eat a food, but you eat a food, it's like termite eating down a building.
Right.
So they eat the food till the food not left to eat.
Right.
The building
the food
down.
Can't reproduce.
No, it can't reproduce. It's too much.
Okay.
It's an influx. The
market. That's a good analogy, dead. Actually. Yes.
That's what happened to Jamaica right now. The market dead. What happened now, they're bringing back vinyl. That's a beautiful thing because it's not too easy to counterfeit vinyl. Mm-hmm. You can't actually. Press and plant, stamp up.
You can't counterfeit vinyl.
You can't do it. Therefore, music will be more protected. I do right. a CD, I do an album, I spend maybe $7,000 to do the thing. Mm-hmm. And before I sell one copy, I walk in Linstead Town and I hear, CD, well, look.
Well, your song the pony.
You have a new, the latest Mark Show, you know.
Yeah, that's almost true.
$100.
No, so they undersell and cheat your product. $100
for something that costs me $7,000.
Bust through caller, you're live.
Yeah.
Caller?
Yeah.
Yeah, you're live.
You're live.
Yeah, man, give thanks and praise. Mark Show now.
Yes, my brethren.
No, man, bless you.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah, man, bless you.
Yeah.
Hearing you,
yeah,
Carla.
Carla, you're not hearing us?
Yeah, yeah, yeah.
Carla, you're going to have to stop listening to your radio.
Yeah, man. Yes.
Yeah, man. I'm all over more sense. I'm all blind to you, sir.
All right, my brethren.
Yeah, man.
Give thanks. Aye, aye.
Yeah, man. That's it.
I saw. Give thanks.
Thanks, Carla. You sound like you're underwater, goggling. We can't hear. But we have another caller. Bust through caller. You're live. Caller, you're live. We don't want you to die, so caller, you're live. He's not there. All right. Max, we're talking about the music and what is happening now. You're talking about the reproduction of it, the cheapening of it. Yeah. You put out a song for $7,000 and them selling it for $100.
Jamaican. Yes.
When you look at that and think of the effort that you put into the music and that is what is the outcome, how do you feel?
Very despondent. It's as if you don't want to spend no more money on the thing. How are you going to spend $7,000 on somebody to approve?
And it's not $7,000.
And they take $100 Jamaican.
That's and sell it back.
That's not even 25 bloody cents.
A lot of times when I see a lot of people selling music, CD, and I said, when I look at them and I say, and I see it in Ochi all the time, mm-hmm. and I say to them, support the artist by going online and buying it,
yes.
or buying it in the relevant areas.
Yeah.
Man, I eat food in a father when I depend that.
Yeah, man.
And when I say to them, they mix with me, yeah. but because I understand the inner workings of the business,
it's terrible, man.
It's very bad.
What do you say to somebody who would view that to say any promotion is good promotion?
Well, promotion is to generate sales, isn't it? So you're going to give me the promotion and you take the sales? It's don't work for me. It better you keep the bloody promotion and let me keep my sales.
Max, I think you spent a little too much time there in London, yeah?
Buzz through caller, you're live.
It's a bit of bloodiness. Buzz through caller, you're live.
L.A.I., bless up yourself.
L.A.I. Well, I'm kissing him.
I am okay. How are you?
Carla, give thanks for link up. Kishim, happy to hear you.
Give thanks, man. Yeah. I have one.
Yeah, you're doing it.
You know what, after you?
Yeah, man. Give shame, friend.
Your original Jatabi from the St. Thomas, man.
Big up St. Thomas.
Yeah, man. Big up Kishim again, man.
Kishim.
Respect.
More strength.
More strength, Kishim. Yeah. All right, you know, Max Romeo right. and family is here. Your thoughts and comments.
Mr. Praise.
It was St. Thomas in the east. Yeah. Where some bearded men keep a big feast. 3 bags of rice and a big black sow. 3 bags of weed was prepared for the feast, but them never run. Wagwan Rasta.
Right.
Highly high. You know, see it. Boy, me I tell you, say, you them full height, man.
Yeah, man.
I listen to them, you know.
Yeah, man,
and them youth, they're going to push it. Them youth, they're going to stand forever, man. You know, see it. The man, them full of melody already. Full of flow already, you know, man.
Give thanks, man.
Yeah, man.
I agree with that. Nice. Them nice.
Yes, I am. Mark.
Yeah,
you
man.
You dreadlocks still live in a tenement yard.
That Jacob Miller, but I have a version, right, in acoustic.
Yeah, man, I hear version, man. Okay. I'll tell you about you now, man. Your version, man.
Yeah.
See?
Yeah, man. That song was recorded.
You're one of the original, man. Me listen all your dope plate and pan stereograph, you know,
yeah. I hear you, man. Give time.
Yeah, man. And I want to keep up the work, same way, and keep the youth them focused, same way, you hear, sir?
Yeah, man, forever, man. No amen, no, not this for me.
Man. Yeah, man. Yeah. No gas thing, you know, see, because a power, you know,
Yeah, man.
Yeah, man, a power, man, you know, see it. And them little youth there, right now, you go going to sit down and just ease out of them youth. They throw me here, them already, you know?
True, man.
Yeah, man, one of them voice, me, I tell you, the man voice full of flow and feel, me, I tell
you,
man.
I know how you know, you know.
Rebel.
Yeah, man.
Maximum respect, King.
Yeah, man.
Bless you, love.
Give thanks, Carla. Yes, my brethren.
You don't know, say, Jatabi, I bless the program, you know, and watch along. Me, I have 2 months say big up. Me can't go to wire.
Yes.
Yeah, man.
All right. Man like Marshy, the juice man. Seen?
Yes.
Man like Bongo Shah.
Yeah.
Seen? And big up yourself.
Bless.
And the Danvers Pen musical crew to seen?
Yes.
Yeah, man. And it's like to say, Irvin. The bus driver, man, Irvin.
Big up.
Yeah. I remember Irvin, man. You know, see it?
I remember for big up Kishim.
Kishim.
Yeah.
Up there, Kishim.
Yeah, man, up there.
All right,
up
all your boys.
Hey, come in. She don't like me for that.
Thank you so much for calling.
Kishim. Bless him up. You don't know. Yeah.
All right, we have only a few minutes remaining. Any parting or uplifting words from the Romeo family?
Well, can I sing?
Of course.
Sure. Not an album, though. Sure. Feel free.
Every man have the strength to attempt anything him want. Don't listen what they say. No make them tell us say you can't. Confidence in oneself. That's all we need. Then all your goals will surely be achieved. Cause the same one. That bash you down today will be the same one that you will put to shame. Just stay strong. Strength is all you need.
Right.
You know, Yana 16, you have been here before. You are an old soul.
I'm 16 years old.
You are. Well, you're an old soul. You have been here before.
You're a mature 16.
Yes.
Beauty queen. That's my name for you.
Yes, beauty queen Zana Romeo.
Ah.
Zana,
okay,
yeah.
If I may sing also, because I am not one of many words.
Okay.
You know, so. Okay. My message to Jamaica is this. Don't let the Babylonah take you away. Don't let the Babylonah take you away. Yeah.
me say, don't let them religion lead you astray. Don't let them division break you away. No, oh, no, oh, 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 way. That's it.
All right.
Right.
I love
right.
It. Yes. EDM the thing, me out.
Well, I just want to say thank you and thank my family and thank everybody for sure. Listening to the radio station right now. And
you're most welcome, sir.
And big respect to you, too.
Give that.
For the right thing.
Right.
It's big up. Big,
big, big up. Yeah. Yeah, man, every time. Max.
Yeah, man, it's a proud moment this to be here in Irie FM. I just wish Mr. Young and Mark was around for me walking at the office and say, Wagwan boss.
I mean, say, hey, Max, hey, yeah. Hey, your time now, you know. hey, do what you do and do it fast.
Yeah, but give me that to Irie FM, still a world of flags, still the number one position. Don't let it go, you know.
Well, I hope so. They can't let it go.
You know, the Amen thing with nobody. You know?
Ah.
You understand?
Yeah, no, Amen. Amen.
And my people out there, give thanks. I hope you're listening, you know. Bonnie Lee and Striker Lee, Liquor Striker, everybody. Nine, even though he has glue on the radio. I just said, give thanks and praise to Jamaica.
Respect.
Man. New government, new time, new attitude.
Right.
Just make we do what we have to do.
Right.
Forget, you know, animosity.
Remember, see your wife today, and she have to talk.
Yeah, man.
All right,
and
she control the money.
By.
Control the money, mommy. Talk them.
I just want to say big up to everybody, and just know that unity is strength.
Every time.
All right, on that note, you say a big thank you to Max Romeo and family.
Thanks to our sponsors. Want to say thanks to Worthy Park Estate, Rumba Rum Truly Jamaican.
And Pickaxe Productions, authentic reggae music.
And of course, we want to say a very special thanks to everyone who made the buzz possible.
Big up for producer Gavin Grant, big up to Cubano, big
Errington
up to
Robertson, Mark Hudson.
And big up to Tony T. Of course, she gave us the social media highs and lows.
Right.
Big up to DJ Brian.
Of course. So on behalf of the entire team, we join you again next week. I'm DJ Bones.
And I'm Kishima Francis. Muta Baruka is up next with the Cutting Edge.
Irie, I didn't lick that.
Here we help you get